3 coplanar points. And bam, there's the race in the earth.
On the level.
The way I phrase it is a monument to the curvature of the earth. It really is.
Level.
And bam, there's the race in the earth.
Put some stickers on there that say, I'm a fucking liar.
Gem.
That would be the most honest thing you could do.
We could get, I can definitely get DP to write you, do you a meme. Gem Panda is a liar. We can do that for you.
Isn't a flat earther here. Don't forget. He isn't a flat earther. This has nothing to do with flat earth.
Yeah, I was making a point about Kosho's memes to make his status better. Yeah, I hear you.
Okay, well, you can fucking shut up.
Wow.
He isn't a flat earther. He doesn't. He thinks the term flat earth means an earth with no mountains and valleys. He used to have flat earth stickers on his spirit level and on his whiteboard. And
trigger stickers, I call them.
But he had to take them all off so that he could keep playing.
They're still on him, Gem. They're still there.
Because he has to. He has to disown the flat earth, lest he get asked.
They're still there, Jim.
Lest he has to support some bullshit idea. But no, all he wants to do is play a silly game.
Flat is 2D.
And people who do this, Bev, do it for one reason.
A plane is 2D.
They're trying to make other people as unhappy as they are.
You think we're unhappy? I'm having a great time.
Speaking about you specifically, man.
Oh, you think I'm unhappy, do you?
I think you're...
If your goal is to make other people unhappy, yes, you are unhappy.
Oh, you think I'm making... Am I making you unhappy?
Your hobby is making other people unhappy.
No, yes. That's not my intention, Gem.
I can have two lines that are level, that are perpendicular to a plane. They're still level, and they're rising vertically. So again,
what?
That shows that you're...
No, you can't have
correct.
A vertical level. You can't. You just simply can't. Stop saying
yes,
it.
Yes, because I can have two lines that are equidistant from a common reference point. They would be level. Doesn't matter what direction they're going in.
Yes, it would.
Because it's a relationship between two
Foolish.
Objects.
Foolish.
Not one.
Foolish. Stop it.
I want to make this point. I think it's true that we are, of course, responsible for our own actions. And what Paige said is generally true in normal life, where we should control ourselves and not just lose it. But this isn't normal life, is it?
A horizontal is established as a plane, right? That's a two-dimensional surface, length times breadth. There's no curvature. But your man earlier had that wrapping round a circle. So he's got implied thingy. Now, if he thinks that is two-dimensional, then we do have a problem. Because I think horizontals are straight lines. And your man, like earlier, thinks that a two-dimensional surface is actually a curve.
You see, the world doesn't care what you think, Bev. We care about laughing at you for being dumb.
But... I'm just going off the mathematical terms of a two-dimensional surface, right?
Clearly, you're not understanding what you literally schooled me on.
Well, only if you can only if you allow for drawing a line in more than one dimension. So if we're in a world that's, okay, we're in a three-dimensional world, and we want to draw the shortest line between two points, and the two points happen to be on a sphere inside this three-dimensional world, then... The shortest line would go in through the center of the sphere. We go into the interior of the sphere. That's not spherical geometry, though. In spherical geometry, that's a two-dimensional world on which the surface of which you're on is going to be curved, okay?
I will give it to you. A two-dimensional surface is a flat. But, I mean, I'm okay with you thinking you live on a two-dimensional surface. I mean, that sounds brilliant to me.
Why do you think we live on a two-dimensional surface, Bev? It's three-dimensional.
You've just argued for your two-dimensional surface.
No, we're talking about spherical geometry before. That's abstract. I'm talking about the reality. We're talking about where we live.
Oh, okay. You all right. Oh, like so it's when not reality then. Brilliant. Fantastic.
When you ask this question, yeah. Can a straight line be exist on a sphere? The answer to that question is going to be yes.
No, the answer
about, that's
is...
That's a question about geometry. That's no. not a question about the Earth. That's not a question about where we live. That's a question about geometry.
Right. You can't have a straight line on the surface of a sphere.
I disagree, as well, all the
what's a tangent, then?
Tangent to the sphere.
What is a tangent?
Tangent to the line.
Is it a straight line? Is it a straight line?
Can I answer your question? Can I answer your question without you interrupting? A tangent is going to be a line that touches the sphere at one point only.
A straight line, is it?
It could be straight, sure.
But you can also have a straight line that is the circumference of a circle.
Yes.
So how do you differentiate between a tangent and a straight line?
Can I finish what I'm saying? If you can also have something that tangents that's curved, you can a curve can tangent at one point.
Oh, what? A curve? Did you just...
A curve can tangent at one point only.
Wow. You've done what? What was that you did on the top of the mountain?
I've measured the horizon drop with elevation.
Okay, so you've gone up... You've gone up to the top of a mountain and you've measured an angle.
Right.
Okay. Brilliant. We had this the other day. I did just say earlier, we had Ruhif do this and Kosho, right? So please, you've gone up a height and you've measured an angle. Please continue.
Yeah,
the plane of flat Earth horizon orbits rise to the eye level.
Which is accurate, which it would. If it was a flat
plane. Explain what you're doing with an angle. The level you use in surveying, does that establish a horizontal plane of reference? From which you can measure a vertical distance from?
Colloquially,
no, it wouldn't.
It wouldn't.
Listen.
Colloquially.
Who said it wouldn't? Who's that?
I said that.
Who's that?
Me, percent.
Percent. All right. So you think an auto level doesn't do what it does?
If it gives you level, it's not going to give you, in terms of the the actual argument here, horizontal. What would give you horizontal is if you have the vertical, the plumb, right? That gives you vertical. Perpendicular to that would give you horizontal. Now, globe earthers would say that horizontal is a tangent line to the globe, to the curve, which is the horizon. You understand? They hold them at different levels. They say the horizon is different from the horizontal. Whereas what I believe it is, and what my experience is, and everything show me is that the horizontal is the horizon. They came up with the word horizontal because it means the suffix. Horizontal, octagonal, pentagonal, all of those means pertaining to. So horizontal means pertaining to the horizon. It's Occam's razor that they thought that, the horizon was flat and because it presents itself to be flat.
Horizontal is definitely a straight line, though, right?
No, horizontal is definitely a straight line, but they don't believe that level is horizontal. They believe the level is the horizon, but the horizon is not horizontal.
I know.
If that makes any sense.
Yeah, and Jesse Kozlowski said it's a measurable drop. The water level drops away from horizontal.
But Bev, you just explain the idea, and then we can see where, or they can try and find out if they disagree anyway.
Still funny that you expected to have done it already, Keeper.
The basic principle of a water level, Ruhif doesn't seem to understand it. Rumpus, the other day, said that horizontals are parallel, which is how surveying works, right? But that Ruhif doesn't agree with that. But Ruhif does agree that level is horizontal. So there is like a disconnect, cognitive dissonance call it, between the model believers and the people that live in reality. I mean, that's basically what it is at the heart of all of this. It's
so why haven't you done it yet?
Can you have two points and then draw a straight line between the two points? What happens? I mean,
you've said it for over a year now.
Yeah, because that's what you do. Like in geometry, if you are drawing a line between two points, it's a straight line.
What are you doing to get this £300 you need?
Who am I talking to?
It doesn't matter who you're talking to.
It does matter. Of course it matters who I'm talking to.
Of course it does.
Who is it I'm talking to?
The question is perfectly valid.
Hey, Scurry, excuse me. Who is this I'm talking to?
Autismo is just above you.
Oh, all right. Is that Gary? Not even my model. Both are your models. It's not straight.
It is straight.
Dude.
All latitudinal lines are straight.
These dudes are crazy. Circles are straight lines. The circles will be squares soon. It'll be fine. It just just redefine the shit.
Wait, hold on. They're not being so sort. You're saying a circle is straight.
Yeah, the latitudinal lines on the sphere are straight lines, and they are parallel.
The crazy chemo. I mean, I've been dealing with this for a year, and they keep telling me I'm the fucking crazy one.
We've sourced it. It is crazy if you don't understand. If you don't understand these basic concepts,
but Bonnie, hold on.
We've given you the links to the sources and the definitions.
If you say to a child, draw a straight line and draw a circle, are they going to draw? What are they going to draw?
Yeah, I don't care, chemo. We've already given you the definition, Bev, for the spherical geometry and what straight lines are. We've already given you that.
I know what a straight line is, dude.
No, you don't. Obviously, you don't.
You can't redefine a straight line and hand it to me and say, now, this is a straight line. It doesn't work. You're fucking crazy if you think you can do that.
Basic concept. I have a question. For all the words in the English language, do they only have one definition each, or do they have multiple
straight
definitions?
Straight doesn't even have a fucking definition.
Nope.
It's elemental.
Do words in the English
you
language
need
have
a straight line to define everything else?
No. I know you're interrupting me, but I'm going to get the answer. In the English language, do words have multiple definitions given a context? Would you agree? Take your time. It's a tough question.
Well, what's your point?
I need an answer because I am going to make a point, but I need this acknowledgement first, whether he agrees or disagrees.
It defines itself, you mung. You're not trying to clarify anything.
I am.
Words here. It is the
don't
word.
Don't save him. Let him answer the question.
It's been answered.
No. Well, let him answer it. Go ahead, Beth.
Go ahead, what?
In the English language, do words have multiple definitions given a particular context?
Yeah, not straight, though.
No. But you acknowledge that they do have definitions.
Yes, words have definitions, and definitions mean nothing to you lot, right? The word straight in geometry has one definition.
The world of geometry disagrees with you.
And that's going to give us what the definition
a
of a 2D straight
plane.
Line.
Well, not a 2D spherical surface.
A
what's a 2D surface then?
You can keep avoiding it, but I
no, you've just you just said a 2D plane, didn't you?
We have to know what the context is.
A 2D, yeah.
Yeah, if you have no room to talk with definitions.
Mathematics. Two dimensions.
You have no room to talk about using definitions. I give you a definition of horizontal that engineers use, and you're still here saying the same bullshit.
What, the horizontal? Dude, you think you gave me a definition of horizontal?
Yep, the one that engineers use. The one that applies to the real
brilliant.
World.
Perpendicular to a plumb line, would that be?
Yep.
Yep.
What establishes the plumb?
Ooh, good question. What makes a plumb line vertical?
You hold it.
Yes, I can hold other things. They don't form verticals, though.
If you put them on the end of a string, they would, wouldn't they?
Yes, that's the question, but why?
Because that's what a plumb bob is. It's just a weight on the end of a string.
I'll take tautology for 1,000, Alex.
I wonder whether the water is horizontal.
Water's always horizontal.
It's
horizontal.
Perpendicular.
Water is wet.
Water's always horizontal, did you just say?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But what's the definition of horizontal?
Brilliant. What's the definition of horizontal?
Yep, go ahead.
Perpendicular to plumb bob, which is vertical.
Okay, is that a flat plane then?
Perpendicular is a straight line.
That's not the definition though, sorry.
Yeah, it is.
Wrong.
Perpendicular is. Yeah, you haven't got a new definition of perpendicular, dude.
No, but I have a proper definition of horizontal that engineers use that you just ignore.
No, I've just told you what it is. You agreed with me. You just don't seem to understand what perpendicular is.
You're using the definitions for, like, geometry on paper, not the real world. Sorry. Try again.
Sorry? Who's this man? This is really bad, right?
None of the ballers are
going to
step in.
No, they don't. They're going to let him. He's the obvious expert here, right? Come on, guys. Surely you've got somebody who knows what they're talking about to come do better than this.
Yeah, we just gave it to you. It was in 2D, giving longitude and latitude, and it was a little of that.
Two dimensions, yeah. Like I said before, length times breadth, that's a plane. Even your man earlier just said a two-dimensional plane. Water is horizontal, he said that too.
This is just proving my theory that you can't teach this type of stuff over Discord. And you're not fundamentally educated enough to do
that. He's not here to learn, though. I think Jam had it correct that he's using this whole flat earth bullshit just to get his, you know, get his kicks.
It's learning the basics.
Maybe say one more time. We're not the average level of flat earther, like someone smarter. Like maybe Lemon is smarter.
He isn't a flat earther, is he? Don't forget. He isn't a flat earther. This has nothing to do with flat earth.
I'm still talking. I hear you.
Okay, well, you can fucking shut up.
Wow.
He isn't a flat earther. He doesn't. He thinks the term flat earth means an earth with no mountains and valleys. He used to have flat earth stickers on his spirit level and on his whiteboard and
trigger
stuff.
Stickers, they call them.
But he had to take them all off so that he could keep playing.
They're still on him, Jem. They're still there.
Because he has to. He has to disown the flat earth. Lest he get asked.
They're still there, Jim.
Lest he has to support some bullshit idea. But no, all he wants to do is play a silly game.
Flat is 2D.
And people who do this, Bev, do it for one reason.
A plane is 2D.
They're trying to make other people as unhappy as they are.
You think we're unhappy? I'm having a great time.
Speaking about you specifically, man.
Oh, you think I'm unhappy, do you?
I think you're.
If your goal is to make other people unhappy, yes, you are unhappy.
Oh, you think I'm making. Am I making you unhappy?
Your hobby is making other people unhappy.
No, yes. That's not my intention, Jem. I'm not making you unhappy, am I?
Less than 20 minutes ago, you said it was.
What? To make you unhappy? I don't intend to make you unhappy, Jim.
You said that's you were not... trying to make people angry. That's
no, I didn't say I was trying to make people angry. I was asking you, were you getting... Yeah, trigger stickers, they do. Like, are you not triggered by them? Jim sounds, he's really, like, he keeps bringing them up all the time.
Well, because it's part of the lie.
The what lie?
Where you were a flat earther and now you've had to disown it. Because you just want to
play. Just add stickers. Just add stickers, Jim. Just add stickers.
If you want me to answer the question, just going to interrupt me in the middle of it.
No, carry on. You tell us about your. Tell us how you get triggered by stickers on spirit levels.
Just call them triggers. The trigger stickers, man.
Yeah. Yeah. I think everyone should cone that note now.
I'm just pointing out it's evidence of your abject dishonesty.
My dishonesty about putting stickers on my level. That I've never hidden from anyone.
You've now took them off your level, right?
No, they are still on the level.
Stream the level now, let's see it.
I can't, can I? Like, you've got video, you've got everything closed off, haven't you?
No, it's not.
What? I have got to show me video.
Oh, so you have got flat earth stickers, so you are a flat earther.
I've said I've not taken the stickers off.
Right. No, that's fine. So you are a flat earther now, and you understand that the term flat earth doesn't mean...
No, I understand it's a misnomer.
because you've been pretending right,
and
that
it, it's definitely it not flat because we measure an elevation change. That makes it from 2D to 3D. That extra vertical element is the 3D element, like I've said all along. Surely you've heard me say this before, Jem.
There is the perfect example of his dishonesty. I challenged him on his flat earth.
Bruce, is that in your background? Have you got a party going on there, Jem?
Where the fuck are you? I'm going to mute you while I speak. He said, this is why it's so frustrating. So, what's the point?
That's not me making that noise.
I accused him of disowning Flat Earth via these stickers. He said.
You're cutting out. There's some other noise. I can't hear what you're saying.
Are you talking over me? Sold me cutting out. Does that stop me from cutting out if you speak all over the top of me? You fucking slimy cunt.
No, somebody else, Jem. Somebody else keeps cutting in all over you.
Flat Earth. He's still got Flat Earth stickers on his level. I say, but he has to because he has to. Up until now, he's been pretending that Flat Earth means no mountains and valleys, just means flat. So I point that out to him. Now he disagrees with that. Says no, I've got Flat Earth.
Got some Pokemon stickers as well.
He's back to pretending that Flat Earth, even though he's got stickers of it.
Got Pokemon stickers.
Yeah. He still thinks
on
that
the
it
level
means
stickers.
No mountains and valleys, and that's why
in
he's
the
got
context
the stickers
of a straight
it,
line.
Even though he doesn't believe
we're on a 2D
there are no
plane or if we're on a spherical object.
And this, Rakia, this is one of your, and Chemo, this is one of your better arguments.
Muted.
This is one of the better ones, according to you. This is the tricky one that we just can't handle. That doesn't even know whether he's a flat earther or not, drops it and assumes it as it's convenient to him, and then changes the meaning of it to his own personal meaning that nobody else in the world uses apart from him, again, when it's convenient to him. He's a slimy, dishonest little fuck.
I've got Pokemon stickers as well, Jem. I'm not a Pokemon. There's plenty of stickers also. I've got a Spaceman sticker as well. I don't think I'm a Spaceman.
You're just a liar, Beth. It's on the internet.
I've definitely got Spaceman stickers. Don't call me a liar. Do you want to see them? Do you want to see me Spaceman stickers?
The only thing I can do to help you is keep pointing out that you are mentally ill. You should go and see.
Is this the more? Is this the debate flat earth and is this the more bit? Has he cut out? Jem, are you all right? Jem?
That got a little too real.
Wow. Did I get disconnected or was that me? Just me?
No.
And this is just more bullshit. This every time he's anything challenging comes up, suddenly it's dead silence. And, did he drop or was it me?
I just dropped.
That's a liar, Bev.
No, I just dropped. Just dropped. I've got some on the level stickers on that. Does that mean I'm on the level as well now?
Put some stickers on there that say, I'm a fucking liar.
Jem?
That would be the most honest thing you could do.
I can definitely get DP to write, do you a meme? Gem Panda is a liar. We can do that for you.
I'm not lying, am I?
You guys get the worst guy to make a meme.
I'm not playing this ridiculous game, arguing about geometry all day long. Pretending it's about flat earth and then pretending it's
not.
Not
pretending about it, Jem. You feel like you've been led on.
Sixth grade geometry.
Yeah, it's been really, really simple geometry. Really simple.
I agree, man.
It basically comes down to perpendicular, doesn't it? And the understanding of what perpendicular means.
The thing is, this is the best you have.
Yeah, because, like, you can't have a perpendicular to a curve, can you? I mean, that'd be
high-flying flat.
It'd work really handy if it was horizontal and the water level was horizontal.
Bev, why can't you have a perpendicular to a curve? You can do that.
Because you can't have an angle to a curve, dude.
Flat Earth proofs. Were your flat Earth proofs, are they about whether the Earth's got no mountains and valleys then? Were you trying to prove that in a video?
No, that was Scott with the two-dimensional surface of a sphere. That's your model.
I'm talking about the video that's on your channel called Flat Earth Proofs.
Where's that?
On your channel.
I don't know.
You know when I say the video on your channel called Flat Earth Proofs? There is no question of where's that after that, because
where does it say that?
If you've heard me say that, you already know the answer to the question of where's that.
Where does it say that, please?
You just said it was titled there,
on the YouTube channel Try Thinking.
Yeah, and there's a video called
The Playlists.
Is there?
They are playlists.
Oh, you just...
I miss
how many questions is
he? Oh, is it? Is it a playlist?
Let's just...
Oh, there's a playlist called Flat Earth Proofs.
Oh, even better.
Oh, right, yeah.
Playlist, even better.
Yeah.
A series of videos that are Flat Earth Proofs.
Sounds like something somebody might do to trigger someone, Gem, right?
Right, let's the other flat earthers hear you say that, okay? So you're pretending to have flat earth proofs on your channel because it might trigger someone.
No.
It's not there because
it's just a playlist, Gem. Just a playlist.
It's something that you've put there to trigger people. Well, that's what you've done.
I've nobody else has ever mentioned it before. So you're the first.
No, they haven't.
So
welcome. They just want to sit here and argue about fucking geometry.
You're the brand newest member of this little club.
The liar that you are. The pretender that you are. The literal pretender.
The admitted pretender.
Right.
Like what Kerf said back in the day. He said the name of your channel, Try Thinking, so that's on your to-do list.
Yeah, always. Always. Thinking of new ways to think about things. Yeah, yeah.
This can bring you no joy. It really can't bring you joy. You'll pay for this.
Can I be heard now?
I'll pay for this. Really? Did you just say that then, Gem?
Yeah, I did.
Wow.
The universe will settle up with you eventually, Bev.
For...
Can you guys hear me?
Wow. This is definitely the morbid, right?
It sure will, Jim.
What the fuck?
And I hope you think about that. Yeah, have a look in the mirror, mate.
I don't come in here lying to people, Paige.
Neither does Bev.
And deliberately trying to make people angry.
he doesn't either.
But he just literally told us he has a playlist on his channel, the specific purpose of which is to trigger people.
No, that he's one person just happens to have been really triggered by it, Gem.
So what's the purpose of the playlist then? Is it because you have an interest in Flat Earth Proofs?
It's a playlist.
Yeah, I know it's a playlist. My question wasn't, what is it? My question was, what is its purpose if... apparently you're not a flat earther and you have you think flat earth means an earth with no mountains and valleys. Why do you have a playlist called Flat Earth Proofs on your channel, Bev?
Because just for moments like this, Gem, I live for them.
So we're back to its only purpose
it's to create just like it's there's only one life, Gem. Is it you? All of us only have one life. Come on. Debate flat earth and more. This is curled, Gem. You shouldn't really debate flat earth and more. You really shouldn't be so triggered by a flat earth playlist.
Oh, you've only one life. And I, the implication being we're all just having fun, and the purpose of this again is to trigger people. That's what you've told us.
You get far too triggered for a guy that you have provided to us is to trigger people.
You haven't said any other purpose. When I throw that one back at you, you deny it or sort of half deny it. But if you have another purpose for it, tell us that purpose.
Excuse me, Jim. If it's meant to trigger people, how come it doesn't trigger me? If that's what it's meant to do, then it's not doing a very good job because it doesn't trigger me.
He says it's there to trigger people.
That's what Bev's saying. No one else is saying that. He absolutely did say that.
Paige, you may not have been here. You may not have been
triggered by it.
No, I definitely did it. I set it as a trap specifically for Gem. The whole thing was just there to trigger Gem. Okay. Yeah, yeah. It's brilliant, right? Yeah.
Okay. I mean,
right, Gem?
It triggers people that know better.
I mean, this guy.
That was brilliant of me. You couldn't imagine that I could imagine that, right?
Such a threat to us, guys.
I bet that's been a few years in the making, Jim. You know, scary. Set it up really well, didn't I?
You're dishonest as fuck, you know.
If you want to keep,
I've got a chicken suit on.
For people who don't like conspiracies,
you guys are so conspiracy-minded.
Pretending to be a flat earther. He only
does
it.
Seriously, Jim,
people.
You think about conspiracies you guys more than I do. You make them up in your head more than I do.
You've got a server.
Look how triggered you're
What's
getting
What's your server
now?
Called, Jim?
I'm just saying,
you're missing the point that Bev has just admitted he's a Poe.
Right.
Bev, what?
He's saying it in front of you, Paige.
Not like Jem's just admitted that he's a triggered...
He's admitting that he's pretending to be a flat earther, and you're not
tricking. He's been tricking you guys the whole time.
You can't understand what he's doing at the moment. I'm sorry, I can't.
All right, hold on.
We do understand what he's doing. He's been pulling the wool over your eyes, Paige.
I can see that.
I've had to mute you, so listen carefully to the question. We're not going to argue about whether flat means no mountains or valleys, because that's retarded. So, are you now saying that he is now pretending that he's only pretending to be a flat earther, and he actually is a flat earther? So, which is it? Is he pretending to be a flat earther, or is he pretending to pretend to be a flat earther? You tell me.
Jem, you're going to Penrose yourself. Watch what you're doing, man. Be careful.
You can keep telling me how triggered I am, and I'm triggered, and I'm about to explode. You can keep saying all these things. It won't make any difference.
And you can keep saying the earth is flat, and it won't make any difference. It's not.
You're answering my question. You can stay muted until you're ready to answer it. Let me know in the chat. Thank you very much.
Wow. This is a really good debate channel, Jim. This is really good.
Where are we up to? Are you pretending to be a flat earther, or are you pretending to pretend to be a flat earther?
I'm just me, Jem. I'm a complete individual. Like you said before, I'm a one alone. I'm a standalone.
And we're back to disowning
a horizontal level waterer.
So he's not a flat earther, as long as we understand that. As long as you're not trying to prove that the earth is flat. When have I ever said that, Jem?
In fact, I must have said many times.
It's just you've got a playlist on your channel that says Flat Earth proves Bev. You've got a Discord server that says debate Flat Earth and more. That suggests, yes, it's a place where people debate Flat Earth and more.
Where the owner gets triggered by flat earth, I'm thinking in a similar way.
I'm thinking in a similar way. The playlist on your channel called Flat Earth Proofs will feature videos claiming to be flat earth proofs.
I will make a further claim that
not a single one of those flat earth proof videos will offer proof that the earth has no mountains or valleys.
Have you seen my proof that level is horizontal?
Good. Yeah, let's talk about that again, Bev, because that isn't totally.
It is a video. Well, it's on my channel, isn't it? And totally it is actually of one of my proofs.
I just said, and I'm obviously the type of guy who's definitely going to drop straight back into arguing about whether level is horizontal.
You asked definitely. Whether there were any proofs, and I said, have you seen my proof?
Hang in there. Any minute now, I'm going to break into arguing about geometry.
Any minute now.
Bev, would you be willing to take a GCSE geometry exam?
No.
He's got an O-level. Chris, in surveying, apparently.
Oh, really? An O-level in surveying?
And a GCSE, I think.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. What's your best qualification in surveying?
I haven't got any.
Anyone? Anyone? Not even a really basic one. Not even an elementary certificate.
Do you need qualifications in surveying to argue about geometry, Bev?
I don't know. I was just wondering why you brought up the qualifications in surveying.
I thought it was all about geometry.
I thought, you brought up the qualifications in surveying. Why did you bring up the qualifications in surveying if it was just about geometry, Jam?
Well, I just mentioned.
I mean, it just sounds a bit far-fetched that you have a GCSE and specifically in surveying.
Yeah, I mean, Logos and all of that shit. Who would imagine?
But it kind of looked real, this certificate, I have to say.
It's definitely real. Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Land surveying.
Oh,
I'm going to give him the qualification as being real.
I'll give him it too.
Still doesn't make him not a twat.
Right.
And very slimy and dishonest.
At least you can say that. That's good.
I want to hear him say,
what are we benefiting from this? What, you know, I don't understand why to commit a fraud, the person has to be like benefiting.
Hold on, where's the word fraud
somehow.
I haven't said anything about it.
No, but I'm just saying the way you guys look at us, that we're lying about this or we're trying to be dishonest in some way.
He's already told us.
Why?
Because in this conversation page, he's told us that his purpose in all of this is solely
just
to people.
Trigger you, Jem.
No,
just you.
He said you. No, you. Yeah, sorry, Jem.
It's all about triggering you, Jem.
When you said this earlier,
everything,
you didn't
everything
say
I do. Everything I do. When I wake up in the morning, I go, I wonder how I can trigger Jem today.
Just out of curiosity, where did you take this?
Do you not know
course?
What sarcasm is, Jem?
Just one second. Where did you take this course, Beth?
College.
Well, let's hear him say it then. Let's hear him say, I want to argue for the flat earth. And by that, I do not mean no mountains and valleys.
Yeah, I know that all of you lot say that level being horizontal is flat earth. I know. Yeah, yeah.
I'm part of the flat earth community. Let's hear you say it, Beth.
We are all part of the Flat Earth community, Jem. That's why we're here. We're on a debate Flat Earth and More server, right? This is definitely Flat Earth community, isn't it?
Honestly, man. Nobody means when he says Flat Earth.
Isn't it? Isn't that what we're doing here, Jem? Isn't there a big, happy community where Flat Earth is and people with servers with debate Flat Earth in the title?
Just admit he's a Flat Earther. Anything he can possibly say.
Like, I've already told you my feelings and understandings of this, Jem. Yes.
Well, you need the definition.
You've already told me your deliberate misunderstanding of the term flat earth.
It's two dimensional, Jem. It's the two dimensional thing that I have a problem with. Right? I could never say that I live on a two dimensional surface when I'm as you know I've got qualifications in surveyors. Yeah, I'm very literal. I'm very, very literal.
You're misunderstanding and misusing the word, not us. You are right. You're so saying flat means that it's got hills and valleys. We're saying flat means that it's actually
two dimensional.
You're the ones misunderstanding and misusing.
Right, okay, I accept the correction, Paige, but let's just explore that. So, as I understand it, there's a flat Earth community on YouTube.
Is that?
Shut up, Bev.
We're in it now, aren't we?
There are now... Well, why did you say is there, and we're in it now, aren't we?
Because that's what I'm like.
Because the first question is...
Keep going, Tim, you're doing well. Come on.
And the second one is, why are you talking about that thing like that? We're already... That thing exists, and we're in it. They're totally contradictory statements, Bev.
Yeah, it's like somebody saying that a straight line can be a curved line at the same time.
Deliberately.
Straight line and a circle. They're both the same. Same thing. I'm practicing.
So, Paige.
You never know, I might turn.
There's a flat earth community.
You might be able to turn me.
There are people who call themselves flat earthers that hand out flat earth flyers. There are people that make debunking videos about flat earth. None of those people, none of them, as I understand it, and correct me if I'm wrong, none of those people, when they use the term flat earth, are talking about an earth with no mountains and valleys. If any of them are, please give me an example.
We're not talking to those people though, Jim. You're talking to us. You're talking to Bev. So why do you even care what those other people say?
Yeah, no. I think they're a measure.
Can't I be different?
At least of what the term flat earth means and how it is commonly understood.
Can I be different?
The meaning of it as people understand it.
Am I allowed to be different?
It never, ever, ever, ever means an earth with no mountains and valleys. Doesn't ever mean that. It always means an earth that's not a globe, that's probably, you know, disc-like or an infinite plane. It means a flat earth. So flat, not going round a ball,
2D.
But with mountains and valleys on it. You know it means that. Bev knows it means
flat's
that.
Flat's 2D.
Those millions of videos are all using that meaning of it. Now, if you've got your own meaning of it, your own separate one, and that you don't announce that in advance, why? What's the purpose of that? It can only be misunderstood, can't it? If you're using a different meaning to everyone else on Earth, and you don't tell them in advance, meaning is always, without fail, going to be misunderstood. That's the purpose of it. It's to create confusion and frustration and allow Bev a get out so that if someone asks him about flat earth, instead of talking about flat earth or him having to admit that he is a flat earther, he can just get into an argument about whether there's mountains and valleys and he isn't saying that. It's just another piece of his game. And I don't know why you want to support someone that is just here to play this game. Don't understand it. Go ahead. I will not speak again.
Jem, you have continuously muted me the whole time I've been here. You Jim. Don't get this kind of behaviour at Brandon's from us. I don't treat you like this.
I was muted within 5 minutes last time I went on Brandon's.
Jem, I've never treated you like that. I always treat you with respect and I'm nice to you.
Me constantly. You muted me
within 5 minutes of my first trip over to Ranty's.
Jem, you are on a huge power trip at the moment.
Mute your mic, mate.
The whole time you've had this server. Now I understand what people say when they come and tell me what happens to them here. Now I can go, oh, right, yeah, I get you. I used to defend you. Now I'll go, you treated me exactly the same. No worries.
Why did you get muted?
Paige, you're a person who just cannot shut the fuck up. I would never have got all those thoughts out uninterrupted without muting you. You'd have interrupted me constantly. Yeah, I wouldn't have got more than four words. I wouldn't have got a whole sentence out without you interrupting. That's why I did it.
What, like you didn't get a sentence out then?
Well, obviously you're going to do it then, aren't you?
Are we on the moor again?
Fucking hell, you people are such liars.
Is that why you muted me too?
I fucking disagree.
I let you talk
me.
When I first got in, yeah. I didn't say a thing for ages.
I told you why I muted you, Beth, because you interrupted twice to say something stupid.
You think everything I say is stupid?
I've been muted for like 10, 15 minutes.
You're totally contradictory.
Why'd you mute me? I witnessed all three of you guys do the exact same thing.
Kosho, you witnessed me getting muted after I said like 10 words.
Yeah, he witnessed me getting muted.
You guys are interrupting. When Jem was saying,
thanks for the backing, Kosho.
Thanks.
No, he asked me, can you hear me talking? I said yes twice, and he muted me.
You very rarely come here.
He asked me if I could hear him talking, and I said yes twice.
Well, you're trying to talk over him.
What was the first reason? What?
Yeah, well said, Paige. Well said.
You never did beat us, Paige.
Yeah, we came here today to prove a point.
No, we never did need you, Jem, because we figured it out, and we're moving forward, and you're still going around on that little bike going nowhere.
Because we were
bikes in a gym that doesn't actually go anywhere.
What would you say is the... You know, what's most indicative of you moving forward, would you say? How is that most obvious?
No drop from horizontal.
Well,
using the water level.
If you guys would
actually
come and spend some time with us, you'd find out. You know how.
Yeah, I'd be doing that now.
The majority of the arguments you guys bring up are things we discussed 5 years ago.
We're spending
time. And we're just having to go around and around and around with you.
We're spending time together now, so, and I'm asking you now. So, in what way would
you
say
that? You don't want to know about what we think about
I'm
what things
you.
Are because you
what
can't even get
you?
Past the fact that you don't think it's a ball.
So, in what way would you say that Flat Earth has moved forward?
If I started talking to you about what I personally think reality actually is, you would spin out. You'd lose your mind.
I just want you to tell me how you think
you're not on a ball. You haven't even taken the first step, let alone...
What area?
He's obsessed with flat Earth. Watch out, Paige.
I'm interested in this. What is?
To know how you think it's.
Yeah, I don't want to talk about this.
I'm interested in this internet movement of people who think the Earth has no mountains and valleys. So, how has it moved forward, Paige?
You mean the ones that think they live on a 2D surface, Jem?
Well, apparently, that's what flat Earth means, right?
No.
I hear what they say.
No, that's your two-dimensional surface, right?
Okay, understood.
Yeah. Spherical geometry is the geometry of the two-dimensional surface of a sphere.
I mean, if you're
I mean, that's where you think you live, right?
As long as we understand that you aren't flat Earthers, even though Paige has said that flat Earth is moving forward, as long as we understand that
I'm
you're
on the level. Reality's moving
flat Earth stickers on your level, and a playlist on your channel called Flat Earth Priest.
Yeah, and a guy that owns a Discord server that gets triggered by flat Earthers. Is that why you're getting triggered then? Because I'm not a flat earther, right? Wow.
If this is a video for Christians, he would automatically become a Christian, would he?
Such a liar.
Use that word.
Are you flat earthers? Just tell us. Are you or not?
I have some good friends that I've developed around here, Jem. Right? Some very good people and some good minds that work together very well. No, it's fine for you laughing, mate. Right.
Dispute about
who would you say are the good
No, I've had a great time.
Yeah, who's got the finest mind, Bev?
Yeah.
Who?
Hey, Jim, you let him
who's
do
your
it,
finest
by
mind?
The way.
Who do I y'all think has the it. Finest mind around
y'all
here?
Y'all let him avoid answering the question by asking another question. Just let
Dude, him I've asked a question.
I've said it. Emma.
Emma.
Yeah, yeah.
Finest mind.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll second that. Emma's brilliant.
She's sharper than anyone.
Greatest mind in flat Earth.
In flat Earth?
I lie.
No, in the community of the friends that I have met around here. Yes.
Hold on, update everyone. They're no longer flat Earthers. Okay, update.
We never have been. Have you never heard?
They're flat Earthers again. I don't know. Paige just said the flat Earth community.
Why do you have to change?
Jem is so triggered, right? So triggered.
Yeah. Does it upset you that much?
You've got flat Earth proofs playlist on your channel.
Yep.
So.
Yeah, I've got a level is horizontal proof that I've done myself.
I've never heard you argue.
Of arguing with like 14-year-old boys at school.
Do you have any globe earth proof?
Bev, let me ask you this. Of the videos in your flat earth proofs playlist,
I wouldn't know. I've never.
How many of them are you that the Earth has? How many of them are you that this the Earth has no mountains?
Gem, I don't even know.
I'm going to make a guess that it's zero.
I don't even know what videos are on it. That's how little I care about that particular playlist, Gem.
Well, I really care about it, so have a guess for me.
I haven't got a clue, Gem. I don't even know what videos are on that playlist.
Okay, all right.
Which one's your favourite?
This is the best you've got, Chemo.
Which one's your favourite?
I fire this guy.
Who's your second finest flyer, mind friend? And don't go with some fucking obscure person who barely ever fucking makes arguments or speaks.
A flat earth mind.
No, your finest mind or that you would consider an ally.
I don't know. Why? Who's yours best? Who would you consider the best on your side? I've already given you one from my side. Who would you consider, right? Your best mind within your community right now.
He does it again, folks, answering a question with a question. Like a professional Poe he is.
I've already answered one, haven't I?
I'm a big fan
one
of
one for one.
Yeah, he's already given one.
Slack is great.
I wasn't asking you, Gem.
Negator.
I wasn't asking you, Gem.
Yeah, and you went when I started shouting.
Negator's useless.
Hopefully he'll be back.
Francis is pretty good.
Please come back. I promise.
I don't want to.
Come on, Chris.
Anyone? What?
Who's the best?
Me.
You're the best.
No, I'm the best.
Okay.
Go Show is pretty good.
Yeah, that's probably the most honest answer we've ever gotten.
I'm not being honest.
They would say themselves.
I'm not being honest.
We're not part of the community.
Me.
We're all in our own.
You just don't want to put somebody up. Are you?
Is that what it is?
You guys aren't
flat earthers. You're not part of the flat earth community, are you? So, you know.
No, we're just up for discussion, Gem. That's all.
Chris is in Chris's community.
This is called debate flat earth and more, right? Is this the more bit?
Community.
Or is this the more bit? Or, you know, like, is this what we do? Is that what you do? You just call people flat earthers and hound them until they say they are or they aren't flat earthers, and then what? What's the debate that goes on? Where's the debate bit? Or is that the debate, whether you are a flat earther or you aren't a flat earther? Yes.
That's the debate.
That's it. Right.
I get it now. It's a more general point.
It's kind of hard to have a debate with somebody who won't make a positive claim about anything.
Who? That's the idea. Who's that? Level is horizontal, and I can prove it.
We're not arguing about geometry anymore.
Oh, is that sorted then? That's done and dusted then, right? Yeah, since Ruhif said level is horizontal, then that's it, done and dusted. Level is horizontal. Cheers.
But we're not talking about them. You're talking to us.
Right. Yeah. Level is horizontal, but you just had a guy that said horizontal was the circle around the edge of a sphere. So wouldn't that be level as well? Level is horizontal. You just bend horizontal.
Don't do it.
Right? It's not me that's saying, it's you guys that say this.
Like, we can get rid of all the other arguments if
this is a mental
just sort this one out.
It's a mental illness that we're witnessing.
Yeah, that you bend straight lines. It definitely is a mental illness.
They're bent.
Just have a normal conversation.
You had a
just
horizontal circle?
I bet you he's in DMs now going, quick, talk about geometry, Paige. Talk about geometry. Say geometry things, quick.
You'd be very wrong. You'd be very, very wrong, Gem.
Yeah, if I say it enough, hopefully you guys will start to understand. Yeah.
What? But you and Bev are going to teach us. Is that right?
No.
Well, that seemed to be.
Have you ever heard
across that she's going to get us to understand? Paige, let's be real.
Yeah, you could never make Gem understand.
Yeah, let's be real.
I'm not going to go and teach anyone here about physics, am I?
Gem, I don't want to teach you. I'm giving you arrows, pointing you in directions to look yourself and have some critical thought about the subject. It's
I'm
like
happy.
when you bring I'm you happy. Guys bring in a definition that will say the Earth's a ball. We bring in a definition that says the opposite. And now, instead of just shouting victory, you've got to take the next step and go through all the words and go through physical proofs, things you can actually
because
prove.
Definitions, Paige, are absolutely irrelevant to the argument of whether the Earth is spherical or not. They're entirely irrelevant, as I keep pointing out to Beth. It doesn't matter.
Rubbish, Jim.
Let me finish. It doesn't matter if he gets everyone on Earth, all dictionaries, everywhere, every reference to the word level to say it means horizontal.
Yeah, okay.
Let me finish.
It doesn't change.
See, this is why
yes,
you have
I
to
understand what
it.
You're saying.
No, you don't. You haven't heard it. It doesn't matter if he gets everyone in the world to agree with him. It won't change the shape of the Earth. Won't change it at all. And he's quite
I've said
happy,
that.
Quite proud to admit that that isn't even his goal.
I can't change the shape of the Earth, can I, Gem? Come on. I can't
Maybe.
Do that.
So what is
you
why,
have your truth.
So what is the point in arguing?
We have things
I'm,
in reality that will show
I'm
you
not
like
arguing.
Gem.
You are, Beth.
I'm not. I've got
are.
A proof that level is horizontal. Just debunk it. Go and get it.
Where
debunk
it.
Go.
I don't need to debunk
it. Where is it?
Why would I do that? What on earth
Where
would
is
I do
it?
That?
Well, level just, is horizontal then. Go, brilliant. Fantastic.
You're
How did you prove
your
proof?
Where is the proof?
On my channel.
Something very important here. Bev,
on my channel, it's called so Bev's what? Proof. Level is horizontal.
Yes,
That's
we agree. So what?
No proof.
Brilliant.
So what? The Earth is still a sphere.
Why are you
even
arguing
you
with
that.
Us?
Are you, you're happy with that then, Paige, are you?
I think...
If you agree...
Level is horizontal then, brilliant. I don't know what we're doing here.
It's horizontal.
All right, hold on, Paige. This is the statement. Level is horizontal and the Earth's still a sphere. Are you happy with that?
You can think the Earth is whatever shape you want, Gem.
Yeah, okay.
Level is horizontal. That was the statement.
Reality, thanks.
That's fine. Great. As long as you're not arguing about the shape of the Earth.
I'm not arguing. I've never have been. A horizontal doesn't get affected by what's underneath it in any way, shape, or form.
It sounds like you're arguing about the shape of the Earth now.
No,
but I know
I'm not. Just level is horizontal. That's all I've ever said.
And you're not arguing about anything in reality to do with the shape of the Earth, are you?
Can't you say you're arguing about the shape of water?
Oh, you're a flat waterer.
Yes,
oh.
A horizontal level waterer.
Why can't you just call us on the level?
And all of the water we're talking about exists on Earth, but you're not a flat earther. Understood.
No, because the Earth has elevation changes to it.
I can see, Paige, how flat Earth is marching forward with this great new approach.
It's measured as a height above sea level, like, you know, that vertical distance, Gem.
I'm not saying the Earth's
flat. We say what we mean and mean what we say. That's the difference between your side and our side. We say what we mean and mean what we say.
What do you mean?
You guys
then?
Say stuff and mean something else. And then
what
you
do
at us because we don't agree.
That's not true.
But what do you mean? Use the English language in the way that the English language is normally used.
You know, we don't play
definitional word games with every single word or phrase that is uttered.
We
like
just
Beth.
Say what we mean and mean what we say.
No, you don't. No, you don't.
Definitions have already been.
You play definitional word games with every word that is uttered.
Otherwise, people don't understand what you're talking about. If you start using words and letting them mean other things, people get confused.
You flat earthers have a better time arguing.
People don't understand what you're saying often.
Question for Bev.
Funnily enough, only when I'm
I haven't said a single sentence without their interrupting me.
That's the only time.
That'd be like 99% of the world population then, right?
No, we don't understand normal you. People, you ask somebody, as long as they haven't, as long as you don't bring up the shape of the earth, if you start asking them just normal questions about what water is and what it does and, you know, what a canal does and, you know, what locks are for and all this kind of stuff, they say exactly what Bev says and what I would say and what Emma would say and what, you know, any of us that are on the level would say.
Yeah, so if you're dishonest and take a half-truth approach, you can, you can trick them into saying things that you think confirm.
No, I ask them to think about reality.
Great job, Paige.
No, I ask them to think about reality first, actual water, what it's actually doing in reality.
You're lying.
What is
right?
it doing
you
in reality?
You, that does not happen when you talk to people. It just doesn't.
Yeah, it does. You ask them what water is.
No, it doesn't. And you know.
Let me try to explain what water is. I'd love to hear this proof just that water is flat.
Just live in reality,
right? Just a second. I have a question for Biv.
All they can do is say you
Hey, hello.
Because you are.
Wow.
Hello, I'm talking.
Okay, dude. Okay, no worries.
Biv proof lever.
A geometry argument, dude. I'm not going to let it happen.
No. Biv's proof level is horizontal number one. That's the video. Can you point me to the timestamp where I see your proof?
Just watch the video, mate.
It's 1.5 hour video.
Yeah.
Takes 10 seconds to prove.
Go on then. Zip through it.
No.
Cut it down.
I zipped through it. Special. I didn't see anything. Nothing. You on the board. How did you prove level is a?
Do you know what a
horizontal
proof is? Go on, watch it. You have to watch
on
it,
the
mate.
Board. No.
Yeah.
Told you, reality overrides everything you think.
That's where I live.
Reality,
I live in reality.
What you observe in the world.
That's where horizontal exists, right?
Well, I didn't see no observation there.
Horizontal exists in reality.
I don't care about your words, Biv. You said you have the proof.
Yes, watch the video.
Yeah, I could draw a picture of a unicorn and say it's proof.
Yeah, well, it's okay. I mean, you don't have to take it. It's like Pythagorean theorem, right? Have you ever proved it for yourself?
Yep. Yes, I have.
Right, okay. Now, if you hadn't proved it for yourself, would you think you could just sort of say, "Yeah, I'll leave it"? Or do you think you would have gone and proved it for yourself? Right? You couldn't just say it doesn't exist because you've never actually gone and tried to watch the proof, right?
Bev, if you claimed you proved Pythagorean's theorem for yourself and everybody you showed it to said, that's not a good proof, what would you conclude?
What, that they didn't understand Pythagorean theorem because I'd already proved it to myself,
okay,
right? That's what a proof is.
So what you're assuming...
You understand what a proof is. Bob?
So you're saying there's no possibility that you could actually be wrong and your proof is not a proof?
That level is horizontal?
No, that's not...
I am absolutely 100% certain that level is horizontal because I have proved it to myself.
Why do flat earthers can never answer the question that's been asked of them?
That's
is this a psychological problem?
Go on. What's the question then?
To make people angry.
What's the question, Bob?
I'm not getting angry. I'm just trying to see if I can reach him.
What's the question?
If you gave a proof of Pythagorean's theorem to multiple people, and every one of them who you were confident in their ability to understand mathematics said that is not a proof of Pythagorean's theorem, would you, in your own mind, could you allow yourself to consider the possibility you might be wrong?
If I'd had given them my proof, right, then that would be my proof, right?
Hold on.
A proof is, right? It would then be up to them to disprove that proof.
So that's how
Surely.
Your mind works then. I'm trying to see how your mind
can
works.
You disprove Pythagorean theorem?
To you?
So hold on. So did you ever have geometry in high school or whatever you guys call it there?
Yeah, we did a bit.
Did you ever get any problems wrong?
Oh, I'm sure I did, yeah. Absolutely.
Okay, did you respond to those incorrect problems by saying the teacher didn't understand what you were trying to say?
Are you,
or did you just accept
what are you trying to say, Bob? What are you trying to say? Are you trying to say that if I handed you a proof of Pythagorean theorem and you decided it wasn't a proof of Pythagorean theorem, then your proof that my proof of Pythagorean theorem would be wrong? Is that what you're trying to say, Bob? Are you trying to say that you can disprove my proof? Is that what you're saying?
You can just
Have you seen my proof for level being horizontal?
That's not what I asked. I don't want to move on to that because I know that's a deflection you want to make.
No,
I want to
it's just an understanding of proof.
How many times he has to attempt...
You're deflecting by talking about other things that aren't his proof.
No, we're not. We're talking about this.
Yeah, he is.
We have an understanding of proof.
No, I asked him what he means and how he perceives when people disagree.
What a proof is.
Because this is a psychological phenomenon, right? Some of us, when other people disagree with us, we sit back and we reflect, could I have been wrong on this?
Yeah, he's a psychiatrist.
Yeah, you probably could have been wrong.
And they'll listen to the person. Please, Bev, don't interrupt me. And they'll listen to what the other person says, and they'll think, could I have been wrong? And they'll look at the evidence the other person provides, and look at the reasons the other person gives, and they'll reflect on the possibility that they're actually wrong. And very often we reach the conclusion, oh, goddamn, I was wrong.
Yep.
Because this person showed me something that I had not thought of before.
Yep.
And in the case of a mathematical
You're
proof...
You're just assuming we haven't done that before we declare it a proof.
I didn't assume anything. I'm asking Bev.
Well, go on. Carry on.
And that's asking Bev,
in the
if
form,
you provided this proof of Pythagorean's theorem,
and
everybody you gave it to says, no, there's a big problem right here, and they pointed to it.
Go on, then.
Would you say that you simply don't understand what I did, or would you admit that you're wrong? What do you think you would do
in that situation? Show me where I was wrong within the thing. Go on, explain to me. Is what I'd say.
But here's the hypothetical, right? If all 10 people pointed to the exact same place and said, that's wrong, at what point would you go, even if you didn't understand why they were saying it, at what point would you just have to admit that maybe I don't understand something?
Bob, in order to have a proof, right, there is an end point that you get. This is why they're called proofs. Stop, Bob. Please, let me finish. Bob, please let me finish. Bob, please let me finish when I'm talking. Please let me finish.
There's nothing to finish because you're not answering the question.
I am. I'm trying to explain to you what a proof is to me.
I know what a proof is. That's not the
question. No, I don't want to know that you know what a proof is to you. I want you to know and understand what a proof is to me.
It doesn't listen very well.
No, they never do. They always imagine what they imagine.
He's a psychiatrist. He doesn't listen very well for being a psychiatrist.
Okay, everyone shut up then. Go ahead, Ben.
Right, we've had this discussion quite a few times over at On The Level, what a proof is. Now, a proof, to me, it gives you a definite answer at the end. I mean, it is a proof. It means you are certain about it. There is a proof at the end that cannot be denied. Now, have I ever done Pythagorean theorem? Yes, I have. And would I ever give a proof to somebody that wasn't actually a proof? Then no, because it wouldn't be a proof. If there was a hole, a gaping error in the middle of it, it would not be a proof. And I would never hand that to somebody and say, this is a proof, if I wasn't 100% certain that it was a proof. Right? That's what proofs mean to me.
This applies.
Well, you can be 100% certain and wrong at the same time.
Okay, well, go and watch my video and prove that proof wrong, please.
This applies to the playlist on your channel called Flat Earth Proofs.
I haven't got a clue what's on that. I've already said to that, Gem, like, stop getting triggered by a playlist that I've made on a channel, please.
When you've used the word proofs there, it doesn't mean what you've just said it means then.
Probably not. I haven't got a clue.
All right. So is that a different meaning?
I did that ages ago, Gem. Yeah, I haven't got a clue.
All right. So there's more.
It's just
than
a playlist. It's just a playlist.
There's
Gem.
More than one meaning of the word proof, including.
Yeah,
the
because I had haven't attached my name to it.
Okay. As long as
I have attached my name to one proof, Gem.
As long as we understand that, in fact, there are different meanings of the word proof.
You, yes, you can have, you know, everybody has all sorts of different meanings. And some people, meanings don't even mean anything. There's no new meaning to meaning to some people.
This isn't me, Ben. This is on your channel. This is
everything's, everything's personal, Gem.
On your channel.
Everything's personal. I wouldn't get so triggered about other people, Gem.
You've got a meaning of the word proof for your playlist.
Personal, yes. I have personal, yeah. Yep.
Okay, understand.
Yep.
Okay, go ahead, Scott.
Complete individual, Gem.
I just wanted to clarify.
Yeah, you're trying to put everybody into one box called Flat Earthers and treat us all.
And you're all trying to escape the label.
I'm just trying to establish the meaning of the word
reasons.
Yeah, because Earth's not flat, dude. Why wouldn't we? Like, honestly?
Great length to tell us the very definite meaning of the word proof. It turns out he's got another one as well. But that's fine.
We've got proofs. Proofs are Euclidean geometry is a book full of proofs,
if
isn't it?
If you're so versed in Euclidean geometry, why aren't you willing to take
that's
a
that's sort of, once
test.
I started studying Euclid, I got a better meaning of proof.
You're talking about mathematical proofs? No.
You're talking about actual proof, yeah. I mean, like, the whole proof.
If
proof
you're so
in
versed
what?
In geometry, why aren't you get proof from a high school level test?
Where do you get proofs from?
Well, there's this channel on YouTube called Try Thinking.
What's a proof to you, Gem? Well, what is a proof to you then, Gem? Come on.
I'll go with what it means to you.
You can watch a picture. You look at a picture, and that's a proof, right?
It can be, yeah.
Well, I'd see. I don't have that. That's not a proof to me. I have to have. I have higher standards of proof.
However, it often is for it. You know, generally speaking. A picture of something would be proof, right?
Not for me, no.
But generally, I didn't say for you, though. We've established...
The people are very suggestible and all of that, yeah.
Generally speaking. So, like, for instance, in a court of law, photographic evidence would be absolutely part of making up a proof, right?
A proof?
Yes. Yes. Did you hear the word proof there? Because
I did.
We are actually at the moment discussing
why
the word
did you go
proof.
To a court of and law?
Seriously, dude? And the last thing I said was the word proof. Yeah. So I wonder why you followed that up with the question of a proof.
Okay, so like you go to law then, right? Okay, very good. That's very wordy, isn't it? Law.
It's a place where the term proof is used, right?
Hmm. So what's your understanding of proof within the law setting then?
Well,
evidence,
it would be what makes a jury reach a conclusion.
Mm.
The body of evidence that a jury uses to reach a conclusion.
Yeah, you're just conflating terms, Bev.
No, I would like I say,
no,
I would.
He's a disingenuous piece of shit. He always has.
Well, yeah,
there is.
He's demonstrated that 100 times.
There are 151 proofs for Pythagorean theorem, right?
Right. Well, there's a mathematical proof, and then there's convincing evidence in a legal sense, and those are two different things.
Yeah, that's all I asked was what do you? No, no, I wasn't conflating. I just asked
the two terms.
Didn't I just ask?
Well, you are doing that. You are showing.
What am I doing?
And I think similar to that no name is the way I would normally use the word proof, and I think how most people really use it, although perhaps without thinking about it, is it means the evidence that convinces them of something personally.
Yes. Yeah, it's convincing evidence.
Brilliant. Yeah, personal. It's a personal thing, right? Has to be gained by the person.
In math, a proof, a mathematical proof is not a subjective personal thing.
It has to be gained personally.
No, you're conflating, and you're doing it right now then. If you admit to that, then you're conflating those two terms. So you may want to walk that back before you walk.
No, I would just say that there is a Pythagorean proof, right? But until you've done it, you have no proof. Do you? You have to apply that to gain
conflating two terms.
the fact that a proof, a mathematical proof of Pythagoras' theorem exists means that there's a proof of Pythagoras.
Yeah, yeah, but it has to be gained, is my what I'm trying to say, right?
Evidence, if you want to turn it into the convincing evidence usage of the term, then you're going to have to say it in a different way, because otherwise you're conflating those two terms.
You're going to have to gain that proof personally, is what I'm saying.
No, you don't. No, you don't. And like I said earlier, you can be convinced 100% of a proposition and still be wrong.
Well, I can't be convinced of somebody else's proof until I've gained it for myself.
Well, as
is what I'm saying. Like, I don't know about you guys.
Their evidence,
if you guys might be different
by their proof,
I can't do it. I need to be.
You're
personally.
Right. You can't trick us with your sophistry, because that's literally you are making a sophist's argument. Where if you take these two words that get bandied about a lot, and you take one in a scientific sense or a mathematical sense, and then one in a colloquial sense, and then you conflate them, you can make them the same, and then go, see, it's meaningless.
No,
yeah, that's
I
didn't literally
say
what
that.
Sophistry means.
I said
that's
it's
literally what
it means.
That's why I went through
it's
all that effort.
Personal.
Yeah, exactly.
Clarify.
You think what I'm doing is sophistry?
Yes. Yes, it is.
That is exactly what you're doing. Empty words, meaningless, just empty rhetoric, devoid of
substance. Empty rhetoric of
what?
What substance have you given us?
Hey, Bav. Proof in mathematics is a sequence of inferences that guarantee mathematically that the conclusion is true.
Good to see you back.
So that's.
Did you hear me talking about the elements?
That's what a proof is. Did you hear me?
Yeah. Did you hear me talking about the elements?
Excuse me. Did you hear me? What I said?
No. Go on. Can you repeat it?
No, you didn't hear. You didn't hear it. You didn't hear what I just told you.
No. Can you repeat it, please?
Go ahead, you cunt.
Fuck off, you piece of shit. Fuck off, you. Are you anti-Semitic piece of shit?
We have another fuck off meltdown for 45 minutes,
yeah.
But didn't you say that was your proof in math? Orange, so, quick,
not reality.
Orange.
Everyone just let them fight.
Brenda, you're a boy.
He wasn't talking.
So fuck off with your
what?
with your homophobic and transphobic shit.
Homophobic. I'm not yes. kidding.
Look, man, I got
you're not even a homo.
Fuck off with it.
Entirely
fuck off with it.
You are a prick.
Welcome back, Brenda.
Is he a boy?
I'm just trying to talk. And
do you have a criminal record?
Your bigotry is
look,
just is just is just
like
the problem.
Wow. You can't even come and diss me, Brenda. That's bad.
Graham's on record as having cracked skulls, which means he has a criminal record.
Oh my gosh, Chris, don't add to the drama.
I didn't do anything.
It's Christmas.
So the problem is that Bev doesn't understand what proof means. In a mathematical sense, it means that you have a series of logical mathematical statements that guarantee the truth of the conclusion. And proof, as it is used colloquially, means overwhelming evidence, like used in a trial.
Yeah, have you seen my proof yet?
You've got a concept that you're calling proof.
I don't know. Have you seen it?
Yes, sir, I have.
Wow. We got to disprove it.
Did you hear what Brenda just said?
Tell us the points that you've got. No, I didn't hear what Brenda just said. What was that?
That's the second time I've said it.
Yeah.
It's the second time I've said it. Do you want me to tell you a third time, Bev?
Is that
your
opinion?
What I said is not an opinion. What I said is not an opinion.
It wasn't a question. It was just something, a statement you said. So
no, it wasn't opinion.
Understand what you expect.
It wasn't opinion. What I said is a mathematical fact.
Oh.
Proofs in mathematics.
And what's your point?
Proof, because Bev equivocates.
Remember the last time we talked?
Bev equivocates.
I can remember that.
Between.
Okay.
Hey, are you literally tactically interrupting? Well. Mute
yes,
that bitch.
Yes, yes,
next
he does.
Time she does it, mute her, Jim.
So a proof. So what Bev is doing?
Have a go.
So simply what Bev is doing is he equivocates between the common usage of proof, which means overwhelming evidence that can't be denied, and proof as in proof that 2 + 2 = 4, which is logically necessarily true.
I just said what a proof was to me. No big deal. Agreed. It's just like my personal proof. I told you what proof meant to me.
I don't think you can argue that, though.
I think he might be trying to make the same point.
I literally said, you just made a statement. There was no question or anything. And she's just repeated the statement and said, yeah, I just made that comment. But I got muted for pointing out that it was just a statement. It wasn't a question or anything. Wow, you guys are unreal.
Mm-hmm. So what if it's just a statement? Why is it required to be a question?
Yeah, why did you need to mute me for pointing it out? There was
Pidge,
no
why
question.
Do you have to ban every fucking account I have on Randy?
I muted you because you had
Brenda.
I'll try not to.
Exactly. Only you can control your emotions. It's not up to us. It's up to you.
Yeah, but other people can insult you and stuff like that.
Yeah, as an adult, you can also control your behavior.
And they do it to us too. But all you can do is control your reaction to that.
I think that's true.
And hate and stuff. You're only gonna end up hurting yourself because that hate doesn't
hurt them. Oh, somebody call a fucking Wayne
Freelance
over here. You're the foulest person I've ever met on the internet, and I hung out on 4chan for a couple of months one time.
That's true. That's true. It's true. She is. She is.
I want to make this point. I think it's true that we are, of course, responsible for our own actions. And what Paige said is generally true in normal life. But we should control ourselves and not just lose it. But this isn't normal life, is it? These are people Bev has admitted tonight.
Faceless, nameless potatoes, right, Jem?
These are people who are deliberately, specifically trying to get people angry.
And so
we shouldn't be surprised when people do.
Do you think Bev's just trying to get people angry?
On the internet.
Some things are going to make people angry. And if people are very
faceless, nameless YouTube potatoes, aren't we? Everyone.
They continually play
just
these
characters.
Games to try and make
you have a debate Flat Earth and more channel?
Well, because most people aren't Bev and
Jem's
you.
A triggered one, the one that gets upset at Flat Earthers.
Okay, I'd like to say something.
Most people aren't playing that game. Some people are. Right the Hand is another one. That's why I banned him.
You mean the people that trigger you the most?
Some people just want a good conversation.
You're the only person that's been triggered here today,
Someday,
Jim.
Listen to him doing it right now, Jim.
Okay,
Jim. They're over here. Jim. Slow down for a second, because Reiki admitted in the chat that this is a takeover attempt. This is to prove that they can come over here and take over whenever they want. And so they figure if they get you raving mad.
No, we heard Curved Gone and we thought it might be a bit better.
Like they took over at Runtie's.
That's what we came over here.
They used tactical interruptions.
What are you talking about?
Just specifically to trigger you.
Take over.
They're all a bunch of dishonest people because they know what pisses you off the most.
What are you guys talking about?
One at a time.
Doesn't want us to come over.
He's over here all the time, Rakia.
Look, rude. It's just rude.
What are you talking about, man?
We should not do that then, should we?
You're saying coming over here and taking over what? Isn't this like a server for all to come and
Do you not want us over here?
I don't know. I'm just quoting Rakia. Rakia. I don't know how to pronounce his name.
It's welcome. Rakia.
Everyone is welcome. But people are not welcome if their only goal is to just wind people up. Because that's just not nice. Just, you know, it just ruins everyone's evening.
Is that why you kicked Curved?
I haven't Curved left.
Oh, y'all didn't kick him? He left on his own?
Yeah. He threw a temper tantrum and took his ball and went home.
What?
He'll
is
come
he still
back.
A Glober?
But that was all Scott.
Hey,
I just want to say something real quick. Scott fucking pissed him off and he left.
Okay,
guys, real quick.
Let me try a bit harder.
I know
than
exactly
Paige.
What he's doing.
Paige, let me try a bit harder and see if I've got it right. So what...